Good morning, praise the Lord. Today June 27th, our topic is how to earn tenfold. We are very happy to earn tenfold, no? But how to earn blessings from God tenfold. Luke 19:16 says, Master, your mina has earned 10 more minas. This verse is from a parable told by Jesus Christ to people who thought that the kingdom of God would appear immediately. To dispel that misconception, he told them a parable through which he wanted to tell them that Jesus Christ would be establishing his kingdom only after coming back and that he would be going away for some time. He compared himself to a nobleman who went to a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. It's written in 19:12. Before going, he called 10 of his servants and gave them one mina, it's approximately about £1 each, and asked them to do business till he came back. While he was away, the citizens who hated him sent a delegation saying that they didn't want him to come back. That was the backdrop of the circumstances in which his servants had to work. Later, he came back and asked the servants to give an account for the mina. And the first one brought back 10 minas and said that he earned 10 minas. We'll stop the narration here and ponder on the point. How did he manage to earn 10 from one in such unfavorable conditions and get commendation from his master? Hope you're getting at the same point that I am trying to bring you. We should be on the same page if we want to understand this. What was the reason for his perfect success? The answer will show us the way to please God by using our God-given talents to the maximum for His glory. First thing, we have to walk in the light of God. When we walk in His light, our works would be manifested. That's written in Ephesians 5:13. Second is, we have to raise altars which denote the sacrifices for the glory of God. God's altar was the cross of Christ, which will take us to heaven, but our altars bring tenfold returns. What are these altars? When we set an example by our behavior, we'll be able to attract others to Christ. That's an altar. Second is, our generosity is our altar. Example, Cornelius in Acts 10:2. The whole of 10th chapter is about him. Cornelius was a kind man who wanted his relatives and friends also to come to God. He wanted to bring his friends and relatives to listen to Peter and thus gain spiritual wisdom. That is his altar. Then C is our good works are our altars. Example, Tabitha in Acts 9:36-42. Tabitha had only one talent, which was sewing, and she used her talent to attract widows who were in desperate conditions. She invited them to her house, gave them dresses to wear, and then she taught them about the love of Christ. Let's pray. Please help us to earn tenfold and earn your commendations, O Lord. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen.